How are the rehearsals going, Prime?
Very well up to now, up to their usual standard, I think, which is usually slow up to the last minute and then panic. But it's going okay.
How much time have you put aside this time?
We have a full week here in Shepperton, where we are now, which is without the PA, but we have the monitors, so our stage environment is more or less as it will be. And we have a mock-up of how the lights will be. And then the stuff is dismantled and goes to the States, and we follow it out a week later, and then we have 3 or 4 days with everything, and with John working the PA and everything.
Mm. How much of News of the World are you going to do this time?
News of the World will feature heavily, partly because it's easy to do. Most of the stuff is fairly simple in terms of instrumentation. And it was built around stuff which is easy to do on stage, which really is the first time we've done that since the first album. So there'll be a lot of it. We've already been through 5 or 6 numbers of the new album.
It must be interesting finding that exact balance between new material and old material too, Brian.
Definitely, yes. Because a lot of people come to see a show for the familiar things. And always at the end of any artist's show, generally, when he starts doing the old stuff, people respond in a completely different way. So you have to, as you say, you have to strike the balance between doing the things which people want to hear and doing the things which you think you ought to be introducing them to. Strangely enough, the things that people notice most are the beginning and the end.
Well, it was going to be astronomy, it was going to be physics. I had a group called, I dread to tell you. No, I won't tell you what it was called.
I'll go on.
I think it was called the Mind Boggles. We needed a drummer, so we advertised in my college notice board. We split up 2 or 3 years later, completely disillusioned, because although we'd had a lot of successful gigs and we played colleges and we played pubs and small clubs up and down the country, we just never got anywhere. And that was really the chastening experience which led to the way we decided to organise Queen. I think that was perhaps the biggest influence of all, the failure of that early venture. We were still a group of people without any contacts in the music business, without any way in, it seemed. I used to go and see people at the Marquee, see groups at the Marquee, and think, now how do you get to that situation? And the answer was that people want to book you if they've heard of you, if you've made a record or something like that. How do you get to make records? Well, you get to make records because if you've played at places like the Marquee where people notice you. And it was definitely, so how do you get in? Head up against brick wall department. First of all, we decided we were going to be ready when the opportunity came. So the first job was to rehearse and write to the point where we thought that we had an act worth presenting to the public. The second thing we thought was to make a good demonstration tape. So we took these 4 tracks around to everyone in sight, every record company in England. At that point, most of them were interested, but weren't prepared to commit themselves that much, obviously, because they want to see what the band's like on stage and everything else. And we weren't in a position to be very good on stage. We didn't have the equipment and everything. What we decided to do was go with a production company rather than with a record company. And the deal was that we made the album for the production company, which is something like a middleman. It's between the artist and the record company. We make the album for the production company, they sell it to a record company afterwards. And in retrospect, it's probably the worst thing we ever did.